So they told you Pro Tools isn't for beat makers. They told you you couldn't do any sampling in Pro Tools. I believe this recent update is about to change the game. Hello, my name is Patrick Preston, but my students call me Professor P. Today I want to focus in on this new update in Pro Tools with Splice integration. Abbott must have been eavesdropping on some of my classes and heard what you guys said, because this is what they have dropped. But before we jump into that, I need you to do me a favor. Hit the like, share, and subscribe button. I'm going to be doing a ton of these videos, busting some myths about Pro Tools. So let's jump into the topic. So I've been teaching on the college level for about 4 or 5 years. And the first day of class, one of the things I do is I ask the students, what is their favorite DAW, digital audio workstation? So with that, I get different responses, but most cases it's FL, it's Logic, it's hardly ever Pro Tools. Why? Let me really quickly address what I hear often in class. This one myth you hear is Pro Tools is not for beat makers. Another one is there's no sampler, so you can't be creative. And then this other myth is it's too complicated. There's no loop-based creations and all of those type things. Of course, you know, FL has those things. Logic has those things. Ableton has those things readily available for you. And I like to tell people, when you first start out with Pro Tools, it does feel like it's a blank canvas. But this new integration is crazy to me. So if you know about sampling, you probably have heard of this company called Splice. They are like one of the leaders in sample library. And what I love about them, they have a really great filtering option where you can select from different instruments, select different keys, select different BPMs, and basically drop and drag them into your DAW and utilize them for your composition. This is integrated into Pro Tools. If you know about Pro Tools, you know that they do have a sound base or a workspace where you can actually pull different samples into Pro Tools, but it's so weird. It's weird, and I can understand why a lot of people will go to FL or go to different DAWs. But now with this integration, you have the flexibility of just dropping and dragging it from that list. And if you already have a Splice account, this makes it even better, because it's right there. You can drag it in, and it will also adapt to whatever BPM that you have set in your session. So let's take a look at this. I'm going to create a 4-bar, 8-bar idea with just using stock plugins and Splice integration. So here we go. Let's start by locating the window now for Splice. It's located over by the clips. Normally it was just a clips window. Now they have it to where you can create a floating window that pops out for clips, but it also does the same thing for Splice. You can see what it looks like. But right here we got vocal samples, first thing that pops up. So I'm gonna just pull something from the vocal sample. I'll bring this back over here. Now, one thing to note is if you already have a Splice account, it will call for you to open up your account, and then you can just begin to create from there. So let's go through these vocal samples. Okay. Might go with that one. That's pretty cool. So basically, I just dropped and dragged it into the session, and notice it lines up with the BPM. I have the BPM set to 88. We're ready to go. So let me figure out some type of chord progression. Right now, I have an instance of expand that's selected in here. Use the piano. Go ahead and label this. Make sure you label your tracks before you start recording, by the way. Let me find the key first. Let me modify that a little bit, or release rather. Maybe give it a little cut off. My count off. 1 bar, please. I think I might want to do a variation to kind of give it a little something different. So we'll do this in an 8-bar. We'll overdub record this now. Let's go ahead and add some drums or maybe a bass. Let's do a bass first. Let's do synth cell. Nope. It's not bad. What I want to do with this, let me trick it out a little bit. Thing is hot. Let's bring it down a little bit. Maybe do something with the vocal. Instrument, synth, let's see what we got. All right, A minor, two loops, set of one shots. So another thing I noticed, of course, it'll adjust to the BPM and you can audition while you're looping through your playback. Then you'll be able to hear what it sounds like in context. Well, I like that. So it's imported and it's adjusted to the BPM of the session. Just like that. So let's hear what it sounds like in context. Groove cell. Let's see what we got in there. See if this fits. I just really want to do kick snare for right now. Ooh. Highlight it. Hit the Q. Add another bass. So this keeps you inside of Pro Tools. I don't have to go to another website. I can just stay on my edit screen, drop and drag what I need to drop and drag in, stay in the flow, stay efficient, all of those things. So I have to be honest, I've never really used Play Cell, Synth Cell, Groove Cell. This was my first time actually utilizing those. But I wanted to do it to just prove to you that you can create inside of Pro Tools, but also now with this integration, it's really cool for you to just utilize the samples that you may have with your Splice account and create. It's really a cool situation. I'm so glad that Pro Tools did this. So now when I go back in the classroom, this is something I can add into the mix and let them know like, hey, you don't have to use the other ones. But if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. But hey, you can come over here to the dark side. It's all right. Come on. So I hope this was a myth-busting video. Make sure that you share, subscribe. Until next time.